Hello, everybody.
Hey, 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 hey.
It's the Cologne Podcast.
The Cologne Podcast, yes. That's where we're at.
I'm Ryan.
I'm Myke.
And we are going to be talking about some really fun stuff today.
We are. One of the fun things we need to talk about is our brand new, shiny, beautiful email address that we have at thecolognepodcast@gmail.com.
That is the ColognePodcast@gmail.com.
Let us know you're listening. We're lonely, please.
We're begging you, for real, send us something, anything, even if it's hate mail. I don't even care if it's like a death threat at this point.
Yeah. We really want the emails that tell us which one you like better, Ryan or me.
Ooh. I don't know if I need to know the truth on this stuff, guys.
I probably don't need to know the truth is where it's at. They're going to be like, Ryan has that deep, silky voice. And Myke sounds like a muskrat.
You got the great radio voice. I always love your voice.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome. All right.
I just sound like a bumbling idiot redneck that slurs his words.
Yeah, you know what? Some people like that, like your parents. All right. So let's jump into last night, or let's say we spent the night with a unisex fragrance name, CK1.
Yes.
All right, let's jump into our one night stand of CK1.
Yeah. One night stand review.
Well, that was not a bit I did not want to wake up next to today.
Woke up with a lot of regrets, huh?
Lots of regrets.
And a headache.
Yes. Oh my God. That is a... I said it last time, I'll say it again. It was a very disappointing scent for me. Like, yeah. It's not a... I can't say like it's a bad smell, but it's just so much going on all at one time that you're not allowed to enjoy it as the user. And I don't even know if the person or the people you walk by will be able to enjoy it either.
My thought is that probably each person you walk by will pick up something different.
Yeah, like a headache, maybe a coma.
Migraine, vertigo.
Yeah, they'll catch all those senses.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm hating on a little bit too much. I do think it's a good smell. Be very gentle with what you put on if you're going to wear it. And I think there's definitely somebody out there, their skin, whatever, it probably works with it.
Yeah.
One thing that we noticed was like, we sprayed on the cardstock thing.
Yeah.
And it smells a lot different on that, obviously. Mm-hmm. And then Michael smelled on arm. He was like, man, it smells so much different on you than it does me.
Right.
Which is what we've talked about on previous scents.
Well, we've ran through the gamut of fragrances that have oak moss in the base notes of it or whatever.
Yeah.
And on your skin, I could smell the oak moss, which the kind of earthy smokiness of that made it smell more masculine on you. But all I was picking up on me was like rose petals.
Yeah.
And candles. Regret.
Rose petals, candles, regret.
Exactly. Yeah. Definitely a bed waking up and going, you know what? I'm not sure what happened last night, but let's not talk about it, okay?
Hey, let's keep this between you and me, all right?
Yeah. God bless. He's doing his Arthur Morgan from Red Dead Redemption.
That's right. Yeah. That's for another podcast. Yeah. We both said skip it.
Yes, for sure skip it.
But again, since it pulled out different notes on your skin than my skin, who's to say somebody out there with the perfect pH balance yeah. doesn't, you know, unlock something greater than Creed's Aventus, you know?
For real. I will say this. I think personally still, this is a woman's scent for me.
It feels very feminine.
And with saying that, and we really didn't, I didn't get my wife to try this one. I probably should have. We may revisit this again another time and I can say whether or not I preferred it on her. But I do think there probably are more so women that could pull this off than an average everyday guy.
Yeah. So if you went out and you heard that we were about to do a podcast on this, you got so excited you went out and bought it before you heard our review of it. One thing you may want to do when applying this is do it right when you get out of the shower and your body's still wet.
Yeah.
Water this puppy down.
Or don't put it on your skin at all, because we were talking about this. Maybe just put a spritz on your shirt.
And then put a jacket on over that shirt.
Yeah. It's just, I hate to be so brutal to it because it's such an iconic, you know, as far as just a brand, Calvin Klein, CK1. I mean, it was advertised to hell and back in the day. It was like the trend. But like you said, it's way outdated.
Yeah, that's what I was about to say. That's what we were saying yesterday is it worked for the 90s.
Yeah.
In a way that I really don't think... Because I don't know if our noses have become a little more bougie these days, but we have more sophisticated scents out there now.
Yeah.
With far less ingredients.
Way less. I mean, the list of ingredients on that thing, too, I mean, it's just insane.
But it feels so 90s where it's like, just for $9.99, you're going to get bergamot, rose petals, this, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's like, wow, they crammed a lot into this, you know? It's got to be worth whatever it was, you know, $29.
I guess back in the day, who knows what this thing sold for back in the day? Probably $100 and something, but good Lord, man.
Man, brutal.
Well, there's that. There's CK1. I'm not going to crap on it too much more. I hate to be like the meanest person in the world about it, but it's a scent. It's not, I don't know. I think it's just the fact that too many things are competing to make it enjoyable.
Yeah.
Because it's not an ugly scent. It's not something like, wow, that smells foul. It just has too much going on.
It's a very clean scent. And then on top of the clean, whatever your body pulls out of it, it's going to be plus that.
So there you go.
There we go.
One night stand review.
Okay, let's move on to the scent of the day.
Yeah, speaking of bougie.
Hey, here we go.
Our scent of the day, and I'll let you kind of put this out there, because this is one that you have actually purchased. We've smelled it together before.
I just didn't
pull the trigger.
You introduced me to it.
And funny enough, my wife is the one that wanted me to get it. I've never gotten it. I should have.
So the backstory on this, first of all, we're taking a look at Tom Ford's Ombre Leather.
Ombre Leather by Tom Ford.
The backstory of this is Ryan and I, like we do, we were shocked. Shopping together one day and we were in Dillard's and we were looking for some scent, and or I was probably like, hey man, you should check out this Dolce & Gabbana I've been wearing for 12 years, it smells great. And no, I think I wanted Spice Bomb Extreme was like the new thing that I hadn't tried. We were over there and you said, like, have you smelled Ombre Leather by Tom Ford? And I said, no, that sounds so dumb. And we went over there. I didn't even know what Tom Ford was then, right? So we go over there, we smell it, and I'm like, wow. It just smells like somebody slapped me with a leather jacket, you know? And
it's nice.
And I liked it, you know? So we ended up getting samples of it.
Yeah.
And this is a polarizing scent.
Very.
It's one of these where you're going to show it to somebody and they're going to go, I hate that. But when you put it on and you give it 15, 20 minutes and it kind of melds with your skin, it is a aphrodisiac of sorts.
Yes.
So I think with this one, we got the sample of it. And then within a week or two, I was like, I got to go buy that. So here we are. Why don't you open up the box and give us a little play-by-play?
Ooh, it is a little box. It's expensive for these little toys.
Yeah, yeah.
So this one ran about 110.
It was, a little over $100 for the... I have a 50 mil. I definitely want to get 100 mil because this is one that I... spray sparingly because I don't want to run out of it.
And he looked right at me when he said sparingly, giving me the clue that I better only do one spray of this.
That's right. Yeah.
So I'm going to do one spritz here. Here we go. And okay on the card?
Yeah, yeah. You're good. Okay, there you go. I was just kidding.
Oh, there you go. I'm trying to hand the card stock so it was Cologne.
I'm over here. All right. Same thing.
Oh, man. I forgot to say this, but even when I... was grabbing the box, I could smell it before I even opened the box.
Yeah.
You could smell like that leather.
Right.
And I'm serious. I've smelled leather notes or whatever in some colognes and stuff, but this one nails it. No lie. When you first put this on, it's like I just put on a brand new leather jacket. It is so badass.
Yeah, this is a scent that screams man.
Oh, for sure, 100%.
Super masculine. But what I was saying, I was in Nordstrom's in Dallas, and I went over to the men's cologne section because I heard online that, Nordstrom, they just put samples out for you to take with you rather than go to myfragrancesamples.com to buy a sample. I was like, man, I'll save a little bit of money and see if I can't get a more niche type cologne. If they have it at Nordstrom's, I'll get a sample there for free, you know?
Yeah.
And I can go to myfragrancesamples.com and get something different. But I went over there. I'm obsessed with this brand.
Yeah.
And so I was like, hey, where's your Tom Ford? And the guy said, well, we don't have any for men.
Yeah.
And so I was like, okay. So I looked at some of the other fragrances. As I'm leaving, I walk through the women's fragrance counter, and over by itself is a lone standing Tom Ford boutique or whatever. And it's only Tom Ford fragrances, and it's every one I've ever wanted to smell over there. And I walk over there and I'm talking to the lady, and she's like, well, these are primarily the ones that lean more feminine or unisex.
Yeah.
You know, there weren't a ton of men's fragrances there, but there is a lot of Tom Ford unisex fragrances that are very masculine. So they were there too. And she had Ombre Leather there. And I was like, why do you guys have this then? And she's like, a lot of women surprisingly wear Ombre Leather.
I can see it fitting a woman.
Well, that's the thing, is there's a lot of intrigue. And, you know, I said it the same way yesterday with the CK1 or whatever. I don't think there's anything wrong with men wearing more feminine fragrances or women wearing more masculine fragrances.
Yeah.
Because when we go out and we're looking for a fragrance, we smell and we go, I like that. That's a manly smell. What's the difference in smelling it in a bottle or smelling it on a woman and going, I like that?
Yeah.
And there's something like, I would think someone who goes against like normal conventions of what you would think for what a scent should be and says, I'm going to be a little mysterious and spray this on. Now, the cool thing about Tom Ford fragrances is a lot of them are built to be layered.
Yeah.
And so what a woman might do is put on Ombre Leather, then maybe she puts Lost Cherry on or Rose Prick or something like that, that adds a floral feminine quality to it.
Man, I'm smelling this right now, dude. And it smells so damn good.
Yeah.
This is, to me, personally, out of everything we've smelled prior to even starting this podcast to now.
Yeah.
I have a lot of regret having never purchased this because it's crazy sophisticated to me. Like, I put this on and I feel like my IQ points just went up like by 50. It's a badass smell. This is a clean ass smell. I'm going to be saying a lot of things here in a minute about this
that
probably won't sit with everybody, but even though this is so sophisticated, I'm going to wait for that part.
Okay.
I want to wait till we get into the who we think fits this.
But
let's go over the notes of this.
All right.
So jumping back from the CK1 we just reviewed and coming to this one.
Yes.
CK1 had about 20 top notes.
Yeah, exactly.
And this fragrance only has 6 in the entire thing from top to bottom.
Exactly.
So there's not a lot there, but what is there is really well done. So the top note is cardamom. That's it.
Yeah.
The middle notes are leather and jasmine. And then the base notes are amber, moss, and patchouli.
Right.
And everything's done really well. I will say the leather is the most prominent thing you smell.
It is.
And it smells genuine. That's the best part about it. It doesn't have like a synthetic or fake leather, whatever. It just has a great leather smell. And it's soft. I've noticed it before when it's dried down a little bit. It kind of softens up and gets a little bit, just a teeny sweeter.
Yeah.
But nothing overbearing. This is just a really clean smell, man.
Yeah. The first time I will say experienced it, because it really is an experience.
Yeah.
I was like, that smells like straight gasoline. When she sprayed it on the tester strip for us.
Yeah.
And I mean, you do pick up a lot of that. That's the thing, is with fragrance that has leather in it, you can only make it synthetically.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's not like they can juice a leather jacket and, you know, pour that in there. So it does have the strong, I mean, a strong leather smell that does come across like all the best things we love about gasoline.
Yeah.
You know, if you were outside, you had a weed eater and you were, you know, whatever, weed eating your lawn, and then you come in, you smell like you've been working hard, you know. That's kind of like the good aspect of like, you know, being around a motor or gasoline or something. It's just really masculine.
Yeah, it really is, man.
There are fragrances out there that have leather hints that are feminine.
Yeah.
Like that Creed Love in Black that we need to talk about eventually. But that has a softer leather. But this leather comes through. It's real punchy.
Yeah.
And like the bottling and the packaging for this makes sense. It's like black, matte black.
Yeah.
You know, the bottle has the leather on the front of it that's printed Tom Ford Ombre Leather. You know?
And it does.
It smells, feels like it, just that strong masculine leather.
It does, man. It smells amazing. And to kind of touch a little bit on Tom Ford, I mean, he's a person, but yeah. this brand is fairly new, just right. kind of like Nishini. It's not a house that's been around for a long time.
Right.
But he's been around for a long time, apparently.
Yeah. Ryan introduced me to Tom Ford through Ombre Leather. This yeah. was the first thing. And then I got really obsessed.
Really obsessed, guys. Really,
yeah, yeah. I don't know why, but maybe Ombre Leather, because it was so different than yeah. anything I've ever smelled for colognes before.
Yeah.
This was probably my introduction into this obsession with fragrances.
Yeah.
Because I thought colognes could only be one way.
Yeah.
They all smelt clean. They smelt a little maybe warm or sweet, but I didn't know they could be like illustrating a scenario, yeah. you know? And when yeah. I smell this, you can like envision a scene.
You really can, man.
It's like somebody dressed in all leather working on a V12 engine, you know?
And who's also got the IQ of 200.
Yeah. Like it was just an experience that it's like, you know, you can make a scent that isn't for everyone. And yeah. this one definitely is not for everyone. But whenever I was introduced to it, I was like, man, that is so interesting.
Yeah.
That kind of created this weird obsession that I couldn't stop thinking about it. Had to go out and buy a bottle of it just yeah. to kind of wear it. And then I got interested in Tom Ford. Ryan and I, we're not super fashionista guys.
No.
Like, we probably do everything wrong. We're probably wearing, like, brown shoes with black pants and, you know what I mean? And a blue shirt.
Yeah.
Tom Ford is a huge brand, but we weren't really in the know.
Yeah, no, we don't.
So the obsession kind of created that. And I looked into it and realized, and this was probably, what, 2019?
Yeah.
Something like that. Then I was like, wow, this guy's a movie director. Yeah. Like, this the same guy?
Yeah, you know? You told me that. I didn't even know he was a movie director
yeah,
at all.
Yeah, and I think you'd really like the one that came out in 2016
yeah.
called Nocturnal Animals. Yeah. It's like a drama, thriller type movie. It's really yeah. good. But yeah, so I went and looked into it. Even though his brand, he started in 2005, in the early 90s, he was a creative director for Gucci.
Wow.
And then eventually YSL, when they were acquired by Gucci. From my understanding, Gucci was going down the drain. They were basically breaking up the brand and selling it out.
Wow.
When they brought Tom Ford on.
Wow.
And Tom Ford turned it around and made it what it is today.
That is crazy. I believe it because he's showing it off in just this alone. There's a smart dude behind this making this scent.
Yeah.
He's only been around for his brand.
Yeah, 2005.
2005, but this stuff is good. And everything I've smelled from him, they're all really kind of different. But man, they're all very intriguing.
Yeah.
And he just hits the mark with this. And I'm smelling it again. It's, to me, for me, it's so soft.
Yeah.
The leather doesn't die down quick. The leather's there, but it softens up.
Right.
And it's just, let's get into who wears this.
Yeah. Well, first of all, let me say this. When you first spray it on, you think, my God, I'm going to be a walking billboard for Tom Ford Ombre Leather. But the truth is, it settles down pretty quick. And what it settles into is a very nice scent.
Yes, I agree. So who's the man or woman that wears this?
You kind of talked about it. Maybe it was the Nishini Hashavat you were yeah. talking about. But the guy who is, I think it's a long shirt, rolled up, couple of buttons unbuttoned. It's, you know, this is one of those ones where you could wear it in the cool weather. But it, to me, it smells like a masculine working man that just got dressed up.
Yeah.
If that makes sense.
Yeah. No, I can see all that. And this is where this may go off the rails. You may hate me for saying this. I'm smelling this, and this is, to me, this is one of those fragrances that I feel like if you're a regular guy to a business guy to a mechanic, it don't matter. I really right. think this is a scent or fragrance that anybody that wants to elevate themselves, they put this on.
Right.
Like, I don't care if you're wearing blue jeans and a regular black t-shirt and you're just going wherever, you throw this on, you've elevated yourself, your IQs went up, you're more masculine. There is a persona being built for you from this cologne. I mean, yeah. I'm serious. Like, this is, we can put on stuff all day and we're like, man, that smells good. This yeah. for real, for me, is one of those ones that's like, man, I want to be larger than life today. you throw this thing on and sure. you go walk the street. And yeah, there's going to be people, like you said, it is a scent that there's going to be some that people go, oh, no way. But it's going to hit the right people and they're going to be like, God bless, that is just a badass smell. It's slick. This is super smooth, man.
Yeah, this is a scent that will create a scent memory.
For you know, real, good or bad.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
You know, like, and there'll be things that don't always smell great, but you're like, yeah, you know, grandpa always smelled like pipe tobacco and peppermints or mm-hmm. something like that. This is one of those scents that if you put on will imprint in somebody. If you wear it enough, if this yeah. is like your signature scent, they're going to go, man, Myke smells like he's been, you know, he's a hardworking man who took a bath in patchouli, you know, or something. I don't know. I just, I feel like this is a scent that people are going to go anytime they walk into a tire shop or something like that. And the good parts of that smell yeah. will throw that scent memory of like, oh yeah, this reminds me of that guy
for
wearing
sure.
ombre leather.
I will say my wife loves this scent. And yeah. she, I mean, like it drove her crazy. She loves the smell on me the few times I've tried it. So again, I kind of regret not buying this. I don't know why I never bought it. Maybe because of the time I felt like it was too expensive. But now kind of getting further into these, I'm noticing like really it's not a bad deal.
It's not. So it used to be a lot more expensive.
Really?
The funny thing is, I was telling you, 2016, he came out with that movie, Nocturnal Animals.
Yeah.
2016, Ombre Leather, it was called Ombre Leather 16. It was part of the private blend, which is their more niche fragrances that are more expensive.
Yeah.
And then what they kind of do is that after a while, they'll discontinue it as the private blend and then reintroduce it as the signature scents that come out
gotcha.
That are going to show up at your Dillard's and your Macy's and stuff like that. They're going to have these out with more of the designer fragrances. And I think that happened maybe in 2018. Maybe they switched it over to being that. Again, a lot of this stuff I looked up. I'm not like a Tom Ford specialist they bring in for like A&E, you know?
Man, let's get to it. Mm-hmm. Skip it, sample it, buy it.
Well, I think it's obvious for me. Why don't we start with you?
I think it's obvious for me too. I'm going to tell people they just got to buy this damn thing. Go sample it if you got to. Go to a store, go sample it. And you may not like it, honestly, when you smell it. But just put that bad boy on and walk around your wife, girlfriend, ladies, whatever. I guarantee you somebody's going to go, that's whatever you got on smells freaking amazing. Because it is so weird. It's rugged, but yet it's smart as hell. Like,
yeah.
I'm telling you, like putting on a pair of glasses, you feel smarter. I'm telling you, like this is a sophisticated smell. And I feel like it brings a lot of dignity to somebody. I know that may seem cheesy, but
no,
I'm
not
for
at all.
Real. Like, that's what it is to me. So I say straight up, go sample if you got to, but this is a hard recommend. I think anybody that wants to have something unique to wear, it's not going to be like anything else. That's for sure.
And yeah.
It's kind of good for the price. It's you're only getting, you know, a 50 mil for that price, but still, I recommend it.
Yeah. Here's the thing. It is a cologne or fragrance that comes across as not a cologne.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yep.
I have the feeling that if somebody smells this on you, they're not going to think you're wearing a scent.
Exactly.
They're going to think that's what this guy smells like.
Yes. Which is so different. That's why it stands out to me.
Yeah.
Versus everything else. Everything else wants to catch your attention because it's like, ooh, look at this nice top note of pineapple or burst of fruit or whatever
right.
this. And oh, this one has this unique scent.
Yeah. Smell those smell like fragrances that you'd wear. This is something, again, it's going to be a scent memory for somebody to go, that's just what he smells like.
Yeah, it's so funny. Like, I'm just kind of hearing us how we're sounding out, but you can tell when we really like something.
Yeah.
Because we're so much calmer and like really trying to sell this. Like, I'm telling you guys, this,
we're begging people to buy this.
Yeah, this is something I feel like it's almost underappreciated.
Yeah.
And especially in our neck of the woods, which ironically enough, and it kind of reminds me of this now that I'm thinking about it, we're both in a rural area in Texas here.
Yeah.
And so we've grown up around farms from as far as your eyes can see.
Very blue collar.
Yeah. So for us, this reminds me of like putting on a saddle on a horse, man. Like,
yeah.
It's got that smell. It's rugged. I feel like men around here should be rocking stuff like this because it fits definitely that persona. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's like a Marlboro ad or something. You know?
Yeah.
And again, for our neck of the woods, ironically enough, we put this on, we stand out like a sore thumb because it's so different. So we really do like this, you know?
Yeah, definitely. I would say the same thing, buy it.
Yeah.
You're probably not going to win everybody with this fragrance. This is one that some people are going to love. Some people will absolutely hate. But I guarantee you, somebody out there is going to spray this on there and their girlfriend's going to be like, you smell like my dad. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like her dad's a mechanic or something like that. That's really, it kind of reminds me, honestly, of my dad.
Yeah.
And ironically, my mom, too. They were both mechanics.
Wow. Okay.
I mean, I'm just like, maybe that's why it clicked so hard for me.
Yeah.
Because it has that very industrial smell to it.
It does.
My dad and mom and me have all worked on classic cars.
Yeah.
And so there's something that smells good about when you get in there and you're moving parts around and stuff and you smell the engine, know?
You're working on a two-barrel carburetor over here.
Yeah, I'm working on a go-kart. They're working on, you know, a Mach 1 or whatever. But, hey, I've done a little bit, but I'm definitely not a mechanic, okay? Don't be emailing thecolognepodcast@gmail.com. for questions about, hey, man, my carburetor in this 1968. So, buy it from me, buy it from you. Let's get on into what we're talking about next episode.
So next episode is definitely one of, well, for me, it is the priciest high-end niche fragrance that I've smelled. And it's French, isn't it?
I'm pretty sure.
And we got us a little sample sent to us, and we ordered it. Not like they sent it to us.
Yeah, they weren't like, please, for your review.
Yeah.
You couple of nobodies.
Yeah, we ordered it.
We paid for it.
Yeah. Took a couple of weeks to get here, but it got here, and we are definitely going to be sampling that out, you know, testing that out in the next
I got mine from myfragrancesmells.com. I really did.
We both got it from the actual source. Well, actually, no, you got a clone of it, didn't you?
I did get a clone from Alt Fragrances.
Gotcha.
And we'll probably get into that that episode. But I actually did buy a 5 mil from myfragrancesamples.com.
Nice.
Of, oh, no.
Bleep it out.
Yeah, okay. It's bleeped. No worries.
And for some reason, we'll get into it in the next podcast. He loves to... for some reason.
Well, you're giving it away there, too. I'm bleeping that out as well. All right.
It'll be a good one. I think, again, let's touch back on this, Tom Ford. Badass cologne.
Yep.
Please, for the love of God, people, at the very least, go try it. Let your significant others smell it on you, because I guarantee you, some of you guys are going to walk away and they're going to say, you have to own that, because they want to smell you smelling like that.
Yeah, go out, buy it, and spray it up, y'all.
We gotta get a new tagline.